What did I tell you to think? What did I say?
They're coming straight back. Yeah, they're coming straight back. Right.
So why didn't you fucking come straight back? Because you were hanging out with the ladies, right, ladies' man?
No.
Stop talking!
If I want you to talk, I will stick my hand up your ass and make your lips move. There is a reason I get you to do things in a certain order around here. This is your second day. Do you want it to be your last?
No, I...
You like hanging out on set, don't you?
No, that would be Jane ragging on the newbie.
Because it's glamorous and it's sexy, but guess what? You don't belong there. You belong here with us in the trenches below the line.
What line?
You'll have them all.
Never mind. All you need to know is that you are an office production assistant and that you work for me. That is the chain of command. You got it?
Sure, got it.
Fucking hope so. The production office.
So is it me or is she getting a little softer in old age?
Yeah, I think she is.
Just keep the fucker ticking.
Okay.
Good. Now, take these script revisions to set for approval and then come straight back. No hanging out at the craft truck. No flirty-flirty with the props girl. No fucking around of any kind.
No flirty-flirty for me.
And most importantly, no fucking thinking. What are you laughing at?
Oh, no, not that.
Go.
No, okay.
Get out of here. What a little twat.
Whoa, Janie, that was another classic.
Fucking head. What a fucking day.
Well, pack it up then, because the hot potato is in little Justy's hands now. Good luck, bro.
Gee, thanks.
All right, well, peace out there, bitch fuckers.
Love you. Love your work.
Production. Yeah, let me see if she's still here.
No. I am out of here tonight. I'm taking Chloe to the movies.
It's the big enchilada.
Fucking enchilada? What the cunt does he want now? Hello, Shelley. How are you?
Hi, Jane. Good, brilliant. Listen. I'm sending transport to the office with some of my laundry from the trailer.
Okay, yeah, no problem.
Excellent. Listen, I have to thank you for the amazing job you've done in getting my family settled here. The event planning, the theater tickets, and all that stuff with the dog. I know, you know, it's a hassle, but I really appreciate it.
Well, hey, that's my job. That's what I do.
Right. Anyway, you must be heading out now, correct?
Yeah, I'm taking Chloe to the movies tonight.
Yeah, that's great. Family is what it's all about. It's all about family, Jane.
Family, yeah, it sure is.
Okay, have a good night, love.
Okay, you too, Shelley. Take care. Bye-bye.
What the fuck was that all about?
The enchilada is smoking crack. Plus, I think he wants to fuck me.
Come on. Who doesn't?
You don't, you little homo.
Fuck you. Just trying to, baby.
Please. The last vagina you saw was your mother's.
Bullshahite. Anyway, I hear the enchilada's stooping our lovely second assistant director.
Get out. Who told you that?
Ladies' man.
You believe that little douchebag?
No. Heard it from a camera guy, too.
The fucking enchilada is boning that Ann Naylor twat?
Naylor?
I barely know her.
You brought her.
You fucking Naylor. Fuck off. That is typical. Fucking useless twats holding on to their jobs with their pussies. Fucking enchilada.
Yeah, what a scumbag.
Gross.
Production. Hey, Dick. Yeah, she's still here. You want to talk to her? Cool. Tricky dicky, line one.
Am I ever going to get out of here tonight?
Production.
Hello?
Hey.
Are you on set?
Just finished blocking and we're lighting the first scene.
Well, if you see fucking ladies' man, he's got the script revisions.
Right. Well, I know Shelly's been waiting for those, and we'll take care of it.
Fucking nail her. Just make sure she does her job and gets it to the enchilada.
Don't worry. Ann's all over. Yeah. She'll get it to him.
Talk to you later.
All right.
Oh, hey, what, did Shelley mention some luggage or cleaning or something he needs for New York?
Yes. Look, I really should head out. It's late.
As long as you're on top of it. Listen, I gotta go.
Okay,
production.
Bye.
What is that? Hey, man, what's up? Oh, fuck. Dude, you've got to be kidding me. Well, what do you mean they might confiscate them? That shit has to be in New York tomorrow. We're screwed.
What is it?
Yeah, I know.
Who is it?
Oh, it's Perrier.
Bob Perrier? He's supposed to be on a fucking plane. Oh, man. Put him on hold.
Oh, that's a nightmare.
Put him on hold!
Can you hold? Yeah, hold.
What?
Fucking sparkling water can't get on the plane with the lightsabers.
What? What's he doing? Wearing them in holsters around his waist? They're supposed to be in his carry-on. What's the problem?
Customs is saying they're weapons?
They're lightsabers. They're fucking props. Give me the phone. Bob? Bob. Ugh, lost him. So? What's his plan?
Shit, I don't know.
You don't know. You are making me very paranoid about leaving you alone here tonight.
What are you talking about?
I'm talking about your little chit-chat with sparkling water. You didn't get the information, Justy. What? Where? How?
I'll try him on his cell.
You gotta cut straight to the chase. Get the details, the status. Don't just sit there blithely mumbling like you got a dick in your mouth.
Straight to message?
That's because cell phones cut out at the fucking airport! This is your job. Focus on it. You're not playing weepy pop songs with your emo band here.
We are not emo. That's not fucking fair, Jane.
Get it together, or we're all gonna be in the shitter. Fuck. I'll fucking get it. Production.
Jane, it's Bob.
Okay, Perrier, what's the scoop?
Oh, you wouldn't believe what a fucking night it's been.
Yeah, look, give me your sad tale of woe later. Okay. Right now, I just need the facts, Bob.
Okay. The U.S. Customs guys said they wouldn't let me bring the lightsabers into the country. They're weapons, they said, post 9/11 and stuff.
Yeah, I know
like
all about post 9/11. Look, yeah. We have to do something. You'll just have to overnight them.
Oh, I never thought of that. Okay, oh, but the depot is like maybe an hour away in this traffic, but Jane,
okay,
I'll try.
Go.
Yeah, Jane, I'm going.
And call me right afterwards.
Don't worry, Jane.
Later, dude.
Production.
Hi, Mommy.
Hey, baby. Mommy's running a little late.
I'm wearing my new shoes, and I'm standing at the door.
We're still gonna go to the show, don't worry, okay? I'll be out of here soon.
All right, cool. I just wanted to get there early.
I know you did, and we will.
Production.
I'll call you on my way, okay?
Okay, bye.
Whoa. Perrier. Take it easy. Hold on.
Good. You didn't fucking make it, did you?
No, they were closed. I'm back at the airport now. Fuck, Jane, am I gonna lose my job over this? My son's going to university in September. I just remortgaged
okay,
my
whoa,
house.
Okay, whoa. Christ, Perrier, you are fucking losing it. Like,
I'm sorry.
Get a
I'm
grip,
sorry.
Okay?
Okay.
Actually, no, hang on a second.
Yeah?
You know what?
What?
Don't get a grip.
Huh?
Keep on thinking about your son not being able to go to university, about losing your home, about your name being mud in this industry, and about you never working again.
What? Jane,
no, listen to me. Keep on thinking about all those things, Bob, and go back to customs and tell them your sad story, how you're gonna lose your job, how your life will be fucked, and make sure you cry like a little girl when you're doing it.
Are you fucking kidding?
Do I sound like I'm fucking kidding? No, the customs agents will see a grown man crying, and they'll never imagine he'd be a danger to anyone on that plane.
Oh, Jane, at this point, I'll fucking try anything.
That's my boy. Good luck.
Okay.
And call me.
Okay. Okay, bye.
This better work.
Sparkling water. My life is working out perfectly. It's working out. Boys and girls. Working out perfectly.
You're still here?
No, it's an illusion. I'm a mirage.
Hey, Justy.
Hey.
How's the band?
Awesome. We're playing downstairs at the Lizard Lounge this Saturday night.
You're kidding. You never told me that.
Lizard Lounge.
Tracy here.
That is so gay.
A fa, a ca, yo.
Fuck you.
Fuck you.
Fuck you.
Fuck you.
What? Fuck the airport lost your luggage. Nicole. Holy shit. The airport lost Nicole's luggage.
So she doesn't have her dildo for tonight, so what?
I'm afraid it's a little bit worse than that. A lot worse, actually.
Don't tell me she checked the princess's coronation gown. Fucking don't tell me that. The chainmail jobby, the one that has to be at the fitting in New York tomorrow at 10 a.m.?
Well, it was in the checked baggage.
What? Give me the phone.
I lost her. She wants you to call the airline for her.
Me? Call the airline. Isn't she at the airport?
I don't know. I don't know where she is. She didn't say.
Fucking typical. This is her problem. She's a goddamn costume designer. Fuck. Justy, get the little cunt on the line.
Is this the right time?
Shit.
I'm supposed to take Chloe to the movies tonight. Shit.
Now I'm stuck here. Fucking pool and gym.
Why does she call her that?
Long story. I'll tell you later. Straight to message.
Hello?
Honey. Yeah, something's come up.
I know why you're calling. We're not going, are we? And you promised!
Listen, I'm so sorry. I had to stay at work.
Mom, you always do this. I hate you.
Baby, look, I'm sorry. Look, we can go another time. Really soon, I promise.
Whatever.
There's a big problem here. It's an emergency.
Sure, Mom. You just love your work more than me.
That is not true.
Yeah, work always comes first, and your daughter is just your backup plan.
No!
Yeah. Catch you later.
Whatever.
Baby, listen, I'm gonna call Grandma. I'll get her to come over and stay with you until I get there, okay?
Fuck you!
The fucking language on that kid! My daughter thinks she's my backup plan. Backup. Tracy!
Yeah?
Where's the double of the princess gown? Did Pool and Jim take that too?
I'm not sure.
Would you be a doll and go into lockup and see if it's there? Because we might get fucking lucky here.
Okay.
Great. Thank you. Perrier's flight. Was that the last one out tonight?
Yeah.
Okay, so the earliest is 6 a.m. 6 a.m. 7, 8. Good work.
Production. Oh, man, you are shitting me. That is awesome, yeah. Yeah, I'll tell her. That was sparkling water. That shit worked. He made it through with the lightsabers.
Yes! Thank you, Space Knight.
Excelsior. Oh, yeah, this whole thing worked out without anyone finding out. Not tricky, not enchilada.
And that's the way it should be, my friend. Because what happens below the line...
stays below the line. Production. Oh, hey, Anne.
Nayla, I hardly know her.
What? Oh, no, I'm just happy because I love my job. Mistake? What kind of mistake? Well, you're gonna have to talk to Jane about that. Yeah, Jane books the cast. No, she's still here. Yeah, can you hold?
What now?
Naylor says there's a problem with the call sheet. It's missing an actor for the day.
What? Which fucking actor?
Space Lord Fauntleroy.
No Space Lord Fauntleroy in the schedule for today.
Anne, you there? Yeah, sorry about that. Listen, Fauntleroy's not on the schedule. That's why he's not on the call sheet.
I want to talk to her.
Jane wants to talk to you. No, you have to talk to Jane. Hold on.
Grab a script right away and see if Fauntleroy's in scene 42. Anne? The little twat hung up on me.
Yeah, she did not want to talk to you.
I bet she didn't want to talk to me.
Aw, crap. Fauntleroy is in scene 42.
Terrific. Great.
Bonjour. You have reached the set cell of...
I'll try tricky cell.
Dick here.
Hello there. Is Anne anywhere near you? I can't get through to her.
Sure. I have her in my sights.
Great. Well, would you mind walking your cell phone over to her, please?
Of course I can.
Thank you.
Oui, this is Anne?
Hello, Anne. This is Jane.
Oh, Jeanne, sorry, I lost you a second ago.
Yeah, that was unfortunate. So why are you telling Justy that we made a mistake on the call sheet?
I did not say that, Jean. All I said was that something was missed.
Yeah, missed by you. It's not on your schedule.
Oh, look, Jean. We can fight or we can try to find this guy and get our day.
Don't give me that officious crap, and don't try pinning this on the office, Anne.
Oh, Jean, I've gotta go. Let me know when you find him, okay?
Fucking kill her!
Production. Oh, hey, Shelley. Yeah, she's still here. Hold on for a sec. It's the enchilada.
Hello, Shelley.
Jane, do we have a problem with our actor today?
Well, there's an issue, but we're dealing with it.
What happened, Jane?
There was a scheduling issue, and so an actor wasn't booked.
Well, where is he now? Do we know where he is?
I'm on it, Shelley. I'm on it. And I'm not gonna leave until I find him, all right?
Fine.
Production.
You keep me in the loop.
Hey, Dick.
Call me the second you locate.
Yeah, can you hold?
I will, absolutely. Bye.
Tricky's on the line.
Get the cast binder out. Call every fucking number you can find for Fauntleroy. We've gotta find this motherfucker or we're foobar. Hey there.
So what the hell is going on with Fauntleroy and Seth?
Wow, the little cunt bag didn't waste much time crying to you in the enchilada.
Jane, you gotta start watching your language. Shelly's gonna catch wind
of
this one.
Yeah, yeah. Whatever.
All right, so, Fauntleroy.
We're looking for him.
What if we can't find him tonight? Can we rebook?
No, that's impossible. He's booked for the next month. On another show?
Shit. Well, his scene is at the bottom of the day, but if I were you, I'd get on this right away.
Okay.
Listen, I gotta go. Good luck.
Thanks. Thanks a lot.
Okay, I called Fauntleroy's home, his cell, his office, his agent's home.
What about his cottage? Did you call his cottage number?
Yep, I did. I'm stalking the bastard.
Fuck.
Production. Hey, Frida. Agent.
Oh.
Thanks for calling me back.
Yeah, you want to book
tonight? No, we're just checking availability.
Yeah, for tonight.
Oh, definitely for tonight. Yeah.
Is this a change of day or an added day?
No, this would be an added day.
Okay.
So, do you know if he's in town or?
Yeah, he's in town, but he's at work.
Okay, excellent.
What's she saying?
And you know he's on a plane tomorrow.
Yeah, we know he's going to Vancouver tomorrow.
Yeah, we know that.
But the call comes in on Lake Simcoe.
Okay.
I don't remember.
Thanks, Frida. Got it. Yeah, bye.
Well, what?
She said he's going to some actor's birthday party.
Okay.
But it's up at a bar near Fauntleroy's cottage.
Do you have the name and number of the bar?
Got the name. Getting the number now.
Okay, well, you call the bar as soon as you have the number, and I will keep trying the airline about this lost cock-sucking baggage. Call them again, Justy.
I already did, Jane. The bar's not answering.
And is his cell phone still going straight to message?
Yep.
Fuck! All right. Send ladies' man on the road. We're gonna have to find him in person and give him Fauntleroy's picture so the little fucknut can't screw this up.
We hope. Production. Oh, hey, Anne. What's up?
Handsome fucker.
Oh, it's not gonna work, Anne.
Put the bitch on.
You have to talk to Jane.
Anne.
Just a sec, Jane. Merci, copy that.
So, Anne, what's going on?
Ah, the producer has an idea. We're back here in a week, so if the actor's unavailable tonight, maybe we can reschedule.
What? Anne, read your deal memo. The actor's on a plane tomorrow and is out of town for the next month. He's on another show as of tomorrow. He's unavailable.
Oh, la la. I am well aware of that, John. But the producer thinks he can convince him to make himself available.
Shelley said this?
Yes, Jeanne. That is what the producer wants.
Well, fine. Sure, whatever.
Let me know. A bientôt, Jeanne.
Bye. What a clusterfuck.
Dude, what are you doing?
Just, you know, just cutting the slides, eh?
Sides. They're called sides, not slides.
Oh, yeah, sorry. So, like, so what are they supposed to do, you
supposed
know?
To do?
Yeah, yeah.
They're the script pages. For the scenes we're shooting in New York.
Oh, yeah, right,
You have no idea what I'm talking about, do you?
No. No,
just
not really.
Skip it. Anyways, you made a mess of these.
This is confusing.
Oh, just fuck it. I'll take care of it. You have to get on the road. No, listen to me. This is very important. Uh-huh. We need to find an actor. He's up at a bar near Cottage Country.
Okay.
Picture of the dude is on my desk. Here's the address.
Right, okay, so like Cottage Country.
Yeah, Cottage Country. Yeah. You have that Ontario map book?
Yeah, I do.
Good. Now check in with Jane before you leave.
Okay.
Production. Nicole, thank God, hold on.
Jane, line two, Pool and Jim, line two.
Fucking finally. Nicole, where the fuck have you been?
Jane, why are you still there?
I'm still here so I can deal with your fuck-ups for you. What do you think?
No need to get testy, Jane. I just got your message.
Message? You mean of the seven or so that I've left on your cell phone? God damn it, Nicole, why didn't you pack the wardrobe in your carry-on?
Well, that was the plan, but it was either the dress or Snowball, and I never travel without her.
No, don't tell me you took your fucking dog on the plane instead of the dress. Don't tell me that.
Well, don't worry, Jane. I left all my numbers with the airline, and I'm sure they'll let me know when they find the bag.
Are you insane? Well, hold on a second. Are you in a bar?
I'm at my hotel.
At the hotel lounge, it sounds like.
Well, there's nothing I can do about it, is there? I might as well have a drink at least. I'm really stressed, Jane. That dress is supposed to be at a fitting tomorrow.
Yeah, no fucking shit!
Hello?
What is wrong with her?
She always does this. Last time she broke a phone.
Are you still there, Jane?
And it was my phone.
Oopsie. Sorry, I dropped the phone, Nicole. Now listen to me. There is no fucking guarantee that you are gonna get your luggage back tomorrow, okay? I have been on the phone with the airline on and off for the past 2 hours.
Really? Oh my God.
Oh my God! But Tracy is looking for the double of the dress. Now, is that here or was that in your fucking luggage too?
No, Jane. That would have made my bag way too heavy.
Keep your cell phone on, Nicole, because I'm going to call you back. Fucking drunk? Pool and Jim took her fucking dog on the plane instead of the wardrobe.
Unfucking believable.
Okay, I got to know why you guys call her that.
Years ago, when she was a fucking intern, she went on location with the show I was on. So she sees her travel memo. And she starts carping to me about how she needs a pool and a gym at the hotel. Can you fucking believe that?
An intern asking for perks.
Oh, I gave her a perk, all right. The fucking broom closet at the Bates Motel. And she's been pool and gym ever since.
You guys.
Like she spends any time at the gym.
Yeah, well, that's what's so funny.
Have you seen the size of her ass? It's gi-fucking-normous.
Hotel'd have to have a separate pool for that ass.
You guys, she can't help it.
She could lay off the butter tarts.
So, was there one?
What?
You know, a pool. Or a gym. The hotel.
Why are you still here?
I'm gone.
Do you have the picture? Why are you going to wardrobe? That boy is deeply stupid.
But he loves the ladies.
You guys.
Ladies man.
Hey, how long does it take to get to Lake Simcoe?
Is he a good road warrior?
He was great yesterday.
Okay, here's the deal with the wardrobe. Getting an answer from the airline at this point? Highly unlikely. So, we get Tracy to pack up the double of the dress.
Okay.
We book the dawn flight to New York City and have someone hand deliver the goddamn thing because we can't afford to take chances anymore.
Who are we gonna get to do that in the middle of the fucking night?
No other choice. The only person we can trust.
The double D.
You bet your sweet ass. But I have to clear this with Tricky first. So, dude, get me the cheapest flight you can to New York City.
This is Dick.
Hey, Dick. Great, I caught you. Listen, I have to tell you what's happening over here.
Did you find that actor yet?
No, that's still unresolved. But we're blitzing on it. We're blitzing.
Oh, really? Just these blitzing, huh?
Yeah? What's that supposed to mean?
Well, let's face it. The kid's just not much of a blitzer, you know?
I don't agree with that.
Well, obviously not. You can't see that he's too laid back for this job. And I also think you dote on him.
You know what? We're not gonna have this conversation right now. I need approval on something. Poole and Jim lost the princess gown.
What? Who lost what? Henry, how you doing?
Hey, yeah. Hello?
Yeah, catch you later. So, what were you saying?
Nicole lost her luggage and the chainmail gown. It was in the bag. She checked the bag and the airline lost the bag. The double of the dress is here and I want Davy to take it down on the dawn flight to New York City.
Christ, so what's this gonna cost me?
Dude, do you have the price yet?
In the LaGuardia, $633.75, JFK the same, Newark, $566.17.
Taxes in?
Of course.
$566 into Newark.
Well, I don't have that in my budget.
Yeah, I know, but what choice do we have? We can't shoot the fucking lame coronation scene without it now, can we?
No, guess we can't.
All right,
we're about to roll here. See if you can find something cheaper.
Something cheaper? What?
It is what it is, I guess. Go ahead.
That man fucking drains me. Just to get Double D on the line, I'm gonna tell Tracy to call Poole and Jim and tell her what's happening because I cannot bear to talk to that drunk one more time.
I'm on it.
Tracy!
No, it's not a problem at all, man. Hey, I always bring my axe along to my day job. Yeah, I'll swing by rehearsal after, catch the tail end. I gotta go now. Yeah, I'm working.
How's it going in here, folks?
Big John.
Big John.
That's my name. Don't wear it out.
What do you have there, my friend?
No idea, darling. They don't pay me to snoop, just to drive.
And a fine driver you are, I might add.
Well, thank you, little lady.
You can put that right here.
All righty, then.
Thanks.
Say, is Tracy still in the back there?
Yeah, I think so.
Well, I'll just go check and see if wardrobe has anything for set.
Okay. The enchilada's dirty laundry.
What? The enchilada's sending us his dirty gitch now?
Yes, he is.
Shouldn't his fucking assistant be dealing with that?
That prissy skag? Please. That's the glamour of the film business, baby. Hey, did you get a hold of Davy D yet?
No.
Why the fuck not? Try him again.
All right.
Well, we've got to make sure he's up for this.
You know that crazy motherfucker, he's up for anything. Just gotta get a hold of him.
Speak.
Double D. What's up, bro? It's Justy. Fuck, I am so glad I got a hold of you. Am I waking you?
No, man, I'm just getting my groove on.
No, I didn't think so. Hey, you up for a little trip to NYC tonight?
What are you talking to him?
Jane will fill you in. Hang on. All right, he's all yours.
Hey, baby, how's it hanging over there?
Oh, you know, it scrapes the floor when I walk.
Yeah, you fucking wish.
What's this all about anyway, Janie?
It's a long story, but before we get into it, I need to know two things. Do you have a valid passport? Do you have a criminal record of any kind?
Well, except for that time I ass-raped that amputee, I'm clean.
It doesn't sound too clean. That sounds pretty fucking messy.
Oh, no. She gave it a good spit shine right after sparkling.
You're
clean.
You're fucking disgusting.
You know it, but no, I don't have a criminal record.
Thank God. Okay, here's the deal. We've got to get the princess gown to a wardrobe fitting at 10 a.m. sharp, okay? So you're going to be taking the 6 a.m. flight out of Pearson.
You guys don't mind if I stay overnight, do you?
No, that'd be cool. You know, it might even be cheaper if you stay the whole weekend. Could you swing that?
Yeah. Awesome.
All right, cool. We'll see you soon.
Later, Janie.
Bye.
You guys got anything else to go back?
No, just what's in the set box, sweetie.
All righty, then. I'm out of here.
Thanks, Big John.
Bye-bye, Big John.
How long do you think it'll take Tracy to pack up that shit? Why am I asking you? Tracy!
Whoa, intercom works, you know.
Fuck off.
No, you fuck off.
What's up? You got some mayo or something on your chin.
Oh, it must be from the tuna salad I had.
Anyway, listen, Double D's coming in at 3. I want transport to take him to the airport at 4. Will you have that lovely dress ready by then?
Absolutely.
That's my girl.
Hi.
She's very perky today. Fuck. Tricky Cell is going straight to message again. Have you heard from ladies, man?
No, his phone's going straight to message now.
What? Jesus motherfucking Christ, that kid is hanging on by a thread. What time is lunch on set, anyway?
Midnight.
Then where's the fucking lunch call? Are they going into penalty or what?
I'll call Naylor.
Please, because I can't bear to talk to that biatch one more time.
Hey, Anne? So are you guys going into meal penalty or... Okay, great. You broke 10 minutes ago.
Yes. Thank you.
Well, you know we need the lunch call as soon as you break so we can send a report to the studio.
Duh.
Yeah, I know you're busy, but...
Busy? Is she fucking with us? Put her on hold.
Jane wants to talk to you. What? Okay. Okay, I'll tell her that.
What was that all about?
She said the enchilada needed her. She had to go.
I'll fucking bet.
But she'll call you later.
Oh, yeah, after she gurgles the enchilada's load.
Ew.
Christ. Get ladies' man to pick us up some lube on the way back.
Lube?
Lube. Because that little bitch is prepping us for a serious fist fucking.
Ouch.
Just make sure transport lets us know who's taking double duty to the airport.
I left a message. They'll call back. We've got time.
Wrong answer, emo. Stay on top. Nothing slips through the cracks. Call them again.
Production.
Hey, it's Doug.
Oh, yeah. Hey, cool. Thanks for calling back.
All right, so listen. Big John's your man. He's going to take double D to the airport.
Great.
All right.
Great. So, okay. Big John's coming back around to pick up Davey.
That's right, my friend.
Awesome.
Around 3:45.
Yeah, thanks.
No problem, buddy.
Yeah, talk to you.
All right.
You know, I'd wipe that little shit-eating grin off my face if I were you.
What?
Well, that was just luck that he happened to call when he did. This office does not run on luck, my friend. It runs on tenacity. What? I'm just telling you.
Yeah, fine. Got it, boss.
Oh, what's your problem now?
My problem? My problem is that nothing ever satisfies me, even when it works out.
Well, don't get your little pussy hairs in a knot. I'm only doing this because I'm trying to make you better at your job.
Jane, we've been working together for 3 years. You gave me my first gig in this rank business, and I'm still here. So why don't you just trust me?
Because I am a control freak. That's why. And guess what? If something fucks up around here, guess whose head is on a platter? Mine.
I know that. I get the chain of command. I'm your man Friday. My loyalty's to you. So why don't you give me some fucking breathing room, and you won't regret it. Production. Yes, Shelley.
Right away.
The enchilada wants you, and he's got his mean voice on.
Imagine my head on a stick. Hi, Shelley.
Jane, I want to speak with this actor. Have you found him yet?
I'm still working on it.
What are the chances of getting him on the set tonight? Time's a-wasting.
Well, we're waiting for some phone calls to be returned, and I should have some answers for you shortly.
Come on, what would you say the odds are?
I couldn't really hazard a guess at this point.
What do you mean? Just ballpark it for me, please.
Don't think I can
Why?
Do
Why
that.
Why can't you? Why? Because it's sports? Just give me an educated guess. Now!
60-40.
60-40? What is that? What does that mean? 60 yes, 40 no? Well, that's not good enough, Jane. I'll be calling you in 30 minutes.
Shelley? Big man hung up on me.
What'd he say?
Those fucking L.A. cocksuckers are all the same.
Did he want a name?
No. Not yet.
Production.
Hey, dude, me.
Ladies, man, thank fucking God.
Does he have him? Does he have him?
Fauntleroy's not there.
Speakerphone. Do you have him?
Oh, wait, he's not here, Jane.
What do you mean he's not fucking there? He's at that party, he's there.
Well, the bartender said he was here, but he left the big group of folks.
Did you ask where they went?
Yeah, I did. The bartender said he didn't know.
Okay, listen to me very carefully. I want you to take that picture and flash it at every table in the fucking place, because somebody has got to know where he's gone.
You want me to ask everyone in the whole bar?
Yeah. Do you have a problem with that?
No.
Good.
No.
Call us when you're done.
Okay, I will.
And
yeah.
Answer your fucking phone.
Okay.
You got running in there, sides?
Yeah. Fuck, this call sheet's a mess.
The fax is fucked. And I can't read Naylor's handwriting.
What do you expect? It must be hard to concentrate when the boss is skull-fucking you.
Jesus, Jane.
What?
I better call her. Hey, Anne, you have a sec to go over some call sheet action? What the fuck was that?
You go check on that bullshit.
Anne, let me call you back.
Production.
Holy shit!
Yeah, no, Jane, I'm sorry, but no one knows where he's gone.
Fuck. Fuck. You talked to everyone. You went into the washrooms, you checked the cubicles,
yeah.
The glory holes.
Oh, yeah, everywhere. He's not
really
here.
Even the glory holes. Did you stick your dick in one of them?
What?
Never fucking mind. What did the people you talked to say?
Oh, well, they all said they seen him. Yeah, one guy, he's gone down to Toronto. Yeah?
One guy?
Yeah,
what?
Yeah, he said he was following some blonde girl around, eh? Oh.
The blonde is his fucking wife,
Jane?
You retard.
Fucking copier's busted.
Oh, sorry.
Somebody stop this ride. I want to get off.
Oh, what?
I'm not talking to you. Shut up. Ladies' man struck out. Is the copier beyond hope?
Oh, yeah. It's copy shop time.
Take ladies' man, tell him to get over to the copy shop and wait.
Madam.
Thank you.
Double D.
My people.
Hey, baby.
The prodigal son has returned.
What's up, my brother?
So, where's my gown? Has the Power Princess worn it yet? Because I want to give the strike zone a good sniff.
Oh, I'm sorry. I think you missed your chance. Tracy has it packed up.
Ooh, Spooge is here. Nice.
Spooge?
Yeah, Spooge, Trace. You know.
What the fuck are you talking about?
Oh my God, you don't know. She's a blaster, dude.
A what?
Okay, listen, you two, you really gotta get out more. She likes to jerk guys off and have them blast their spooge all over her little face. And it's all she likes to do.
Who the fuck told you that, moron?
What, are you fucking kidding me? She's like a walking Bukkake film. A fucking grip circle jerked her last week until her face was like a dripping wet fucking cum rag.
Oh my God, tuna salad.
Oh my God. John!
More like spoon salad.
What's so funny?
We're just retards. Double these stupid stories, you know.
Ooh, my gown. Excellent.
David, this is chainmail, but it's really delicate, so keep that in mind. Be really careful with it.
I will treat it as if it's my own.
You're weird. Well, that's it. You guys are amazing. Not as amazing as you.
What the fuck is a tuna salad?
I can't. You gotta get it.
Production. Ladies' man, what's the good word?
Oh, God.
Okay, excellent. So dudes will put them straight onto the cooker and push every other job they have off to the side, right? Okay, and I want you to get all the manager's info, his dick size, if there's a picture of him with a goat, all of it. We need to make sure he's available to us exactly when we need him, okay? All right, then come straight back. See you then.
Hard ass.
Oh, I just remember what happened when we were shooting overnight in Belleville.
Oh, fuck. Speaking of overnight, where are you staying in New York City?
Well, there's this chick.
Of course.
Dude, I didn't tell you about her last time I went down there with all the boys.
Oh my God, not the chick you teabagged.
That's her.
Fuck.
What? You never told me this.
Dude, it happened during 9/11.
What?
Get out of here. September 11th,
2001. No, it'd be September 11th, 1895. What the fuck do you think, dude? Her apartment was in Tribeca.
Shit, what happened?
Okay, so I'm standing there by the side of the bed, and she's lying there upside down, facing me. And I...
Oh, my God.
I'm just giving her, like, a fucking righteous choke. Right? Like that, don't you, you dirty little bitch.
Oh, my God.
And shh, because my sack is like slapping against the tip of her nose, right?
And,
well, then it got nasty, right? Because I'm standing there facing the window, and I see the first plane flying low over the skyline. The sound was incredible, but I'm gonna ignore it because I'm just about to fucking bust a nut down this little fuck bunny's throat, right? And then, boom, we hear the impact. There was like a fucking earthquake. The whole building shook.
Shit.
So I'm standing there naked at the window watching the first tower burn. That's when the second fucking plane has just hit.
Well, what'd you do?
What the fuck do you think we'd do? We got our clothes and got the fuck out of there, man. And the streets were like a madhouse.
Yeah, I don't know if I'd buy that shit.
Janie, that shit happened.
Yeah, I know that they took the towers down. I just doubt the truthiness of face-fuck 9/11.
Yeah, but I bet you still believe the official line on that fucking farce, don't you? But you don't believe my story?
Oh, this one I have heard before. Still on that kick?
Ain't a kick, my brother. The rich and powerful, they leave nothing to chance. You mean to tell me with all the shit they got, fucking spy satellites bugging, et cetera, they couldn't stop that shit? Give me a fucking break. Dude, in Korea, American forces were bombing southern villages, blaming it on the north, gaining extra funding for the war and fucking public support. That's how it works.
Yep.
The two towers? That gave them carte blanche. Afghanistan? Iraq? That shit's just the beginning, man. Because they're up there in their fucking private jets in their penthouse apartments, and they are planning shit, right? To make them and their oil-rich friends even more powerful.
Fucking Michael Moore over here.
Fuck him! That fat bastard still believes the fucking towers went down because of government incompetence, not because of malice. But I am telling you, best case scenario, they knew. They let it happen. Worst case scenario, they ordered the whole fucking thing. Boom.
Yeah, I don't know.
Dude, wake the fuck up. Big men are in control, always fucking have been, always fucking will be.
Production.
Jesse, I need to talk to my mom.
Oh, hey, Chloe.
Is she still there?
Yeah, she's still here. Yeah, can you hold on?
Hey, sweetie.
Canada's next.
Mom, you're still there? I can't sleep, and I'm hungry.
Sweetie, how can you still be up?
I'm waiting for you.
Oh, honey. I'm so sorry. I have to find this actor, and I can't leave until I do.
What do you mean you have to find him? Has he, like, disappeared or something?
Yeah, kinda. It's a long story. Where's Grandma?
She's asleep in the armchair.
Great.
Mom, I just want you to come home. I miss you.
I miss you too, honey. Thank you, sir.
Dude, what the fuck? You're bringing your dirty BVDs to the office now?
No, that would be the enchiladas.
What, are you shitting me? Oh, God.
Dude, are you sniffing the enchiladas' dirty gitch?
Oh, God, yeah, so fucking what?
What?
You think I give a shit about some dude's dirty gitch?
God, you are such a freak.
Freak? Janie, I will show you a freak. You give me 20 bucks and I will stick this rat bastard's rank-smelling fucking gotchas in my mouth.
This call sheet is fine.
Let me get this straight. You're gonna take a pair of dirty underwear from this bag
and put it in your mouth for $20?
Yep, but let's make it 25 from each of you.
Oh, I am in.
Me too.
I can't really afford that. Huh?
This I have to see, so I will pay for ladies' man.
Spinach. Hey, Trace.
Hi, David.
This is great. Now I can maximize my earnings, make a little extra scratch for New York City.
What's going on?
We're all paying $25 to see Double D stick the enchilada's dirty gitch in his mouth.
For 5 whole seconds.
Oh.
Oh, my God. No.
Oh, my God, yes. But first, show me the fucking money.
Here, 25. Come on.
Come on, come on. Fork
it
over.
Really this hard up
every
yet.
Penny. I get to pick out the article of clothing.
Be my guest.
All right. Oh, I can smell them from here. Okay.
Drum roll, please.
Oh, this is worth 200 at least.
Ew. No. Ew.
Okay. Oh, yeah. Okay.
Ew, what the F are those?
Oh, nice.
All right, kids, y'all ready?
Oh, my goodness.
Eat it.
Will he do this, ladies and gentlemen?
Oh, don't put it in your mouth.
Come on, man. Oh, how's that taste on the top? Have some salt and pepper.
Come on, Steven, that's disgusting.
Yes.
Okay.
Gross. Right. Oh, it's two. Oh, my God. All the way in. Get it all the way in or it doesn't count. Come on. Three.
Oh, my goodness.
Four.
Four.
Four now. Oh.
Oh, yes.
Four and three quarters. It's turn yes, loss.
Okay. Funny. Oh.
Okay, five.
Oh, my God, dude. Five. I cannot believe you did that.
Check it out.
So gross.
He probably shit himself this morning.
Oh, hey, are you guys laughing or crying in here?
Both, actually.
Right on. You about ready to go there, brother?
What, are you fucking kidding me? I got my gown, I got my 100 fazools. Well, I'm fucking out of here.
If you guys are going back to set, can I catch a ride?
Sure thing, little lady.
I guess I better be getting on the road too, eh? Yeah?
Are you fucking kidding?
No.
You're gone already. That was awesome. That was the funniest thing I think I've ever seen in my life.
Best thing ever.
Girls, for a little celebration, my friend.
Yep.
Right on. Oh, my God. Can you believe he fit that big ass floss in his mouth?
Have you seen the trap on that boy?
To the Double D.
Double D.
Ah! Ding, 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 ding! Right. Can you believe the enchilada wears fucking leopard skin underwear?
I pictured him more of a leather man myself.
You pictured him in leather, you freak. Good evening, production.
Jane, where the fuck is our actor?
Shelley. We haven't been,
You haven't been what? Doing what? Your job? Cleaning up your goddamn mess? Do you fucking know what a disaster this is? It's a fucking meltdown! We won't be able to get our show without this fucking scene! The studio's gonna have my head!
Shelley,
It's almost 4 a.m. now, Jane, and you've got less than 90 minutes to find that fat little fuck! You get him to the set, Jane! 90 fucking minutes, or I want a name!
What was that all about?
We've got 90 fucking minutes to get Fauntleroy to set. Our enchilada wants a fucking name.
Well, yeah, I'll give him a name, Nailers.
What? He's banging her! Wake up! Fuck, I should have been checking the schedule against the script. I usually do.
I should have been on the lookout, too.
Yeah, well, coulda, shoulda, woulda. Doesn't matter now, because looks like I'm gonna totally wear this if we don't find Lord Fuckface.
I'm gonna try calling his wife again.
Yeah. Fuck me.
Oh, man. I'm so fucking tired.
Well, I'd tell you to go home, but I know that would be useless. So, how about a cup of coffee instead? Just made a fresh pot.
Great. Thanks, Justy. You know, some people go home at 5 p.m. to see their families. Have you heard of these people?
Freaks. Come on, Jane, you're not planning on giving up the life, are you?
What life? Call this a life? One fucking thing goes awry, and everything you do gets called into question.
It's the way the system works.
Yeah, well, the system sucks ass. Look what the cat dragged in.
So, you made it back, finally.
Oh, yeah, just like you said.
What's the word on set?
Ooh, same old, you know? I just dropped the call sheets off with the ADs, and I came right back.
Good. Which AD? Naylor, I hope?
No, no, she wasn't around.
Yeah, she was probably giving the enchilada a rim job in the Winnie.
Which one's the enchilada again?
Shelly? The producer from L.A.?
Oh, yeah. No, wasn't him this time.
You're kidding. She's cheating on the enchilada?
Chick's incredible. D.O.C.
Yeah.
D.O.C.
Jesus Christ. Don't you even watch pornography? Drunk? On cock?
Oh, yeah.
Well, who was it then?
I heard it was the what's his name? The Rick. Yeah, Rick. You know Rick, like the production manager guy.
What?
Oh, yeah. Folks say they've been humping in the honey wagon. Yeah, past few days.
That's motherfucking bullshit. Who told you that?
What?
Who told you that?
Oh, right. The makeup girls. Yeah, they caught them coming out of one of the rooms together earlier tonight.
Well, they're fucking liars, and you're a fucking idiot for believing them. You drive me fucking crazy. Justy, watch the phones. I gotta go to the can.
But the grips, too.
Dude, have you lost your fucking mind?
What?
What? Oh, you have no clue, do you? They're married. They're fucking married.
Oh, yeah. Okay. Who?
Jane and Tricky? Dick. Dick, not Rick. They're married, you fucking moron.
Oh, Lordy. It's not just me, okay? Everybody's talking about it.
Jesus. Backstabbing cocksucker. I could kill him.
You know where Amato's Pizza is?
Nope.
West End. It's open all night. Go get yourself a slice or something. Just get the fuck out of here.
But I'm not. You know.
I know. Just go before she shoots the messenger, okay?
But the messenger's innocent.
Just fucking go. Go.
Okay, I'm going.
And I'll call you.
Jane, I'm so fucking sorry.
What are you sorry about? Did you know about this?
No.
Well, don't believe everything you hear on set. Where did the fucking caper go?
I sent him out on a run.
Yeah, well, it'll be his last fucking run before I fire his sorry ass.
Hey, listen, I know, but he's not such a bad kid.
He's dumb and he's a liar. He didn't come straight back from set. He was busy chatting up the pretties for gossip.
Production. Hi, Shelley. Yeah, she's still here, but she's in the washroom. Shall I have her give you a call back? No, we haven't found him yet. Right. Right, okay, then no need for Jane to call you back then. Thank you, Shelley. Bye.
I
got it. Production.
Hi, are you trying to call from Jane?
May I see who's calling?
This is Sandra, Freddy calls.
Can you hold on, please? Jane Fauntleroy's wife.
You're kidding. Oh my God, this is great. Sandra, hi. Thanks for calling me back.
Jane, listen, I'm sorry, but Freddy's not home.
He's not.
No, he went to a party up north.
Yeah.
A stag party, you know, boys' night out kind of thing.
A stag party? Really?
Yeah, so he probably won't be home till, I don't know, around noon.
Oh. Listen, it's really important. It's about work. We want to get him to set tonight.
You production people, I think the night's about over, Jane.
Well, if you hear from him, would you ask him to call the office immediately?
Okay. Listen, I've got to go to work now.
All right, thanks a lot, Sandra. Bye-bye.
All right, bye.
What'd she say?
Remember the blonde that ladies' man said Fauntleroy was chasing around at the bar up north? Well, apparently, that wasn't his wife.
What the fuck?
And if that wasn't his wife, then I think I have a pretty good idea of who it might be.
The fuck you talking about?
Remember all the set drama with Fauntleroy on Space Nights 2? All that gossip about him and the Queen of Freedom Planet?
Oh, yeah. That Sylvia Green chick, she was a piece of work.
And blonde.
Oh, no. You think?
It's worth a fucking try.
What? You're not calling her now, are you?
Why the fuck not?
Fuck, Jane, what are you gonna do? Accuse her of having an affair with Fauntleroy? It's 5 a.m. What if you're off base?
Who cares? Listen, we are neck deep in the shitter here. What have we got to lose? Enchilada wants a fucking name.
Yeah, I know, but...
Okay, well, then I'll give him your name. You don't want me to do that? Then I guess we're gonna call Sylvia.
Hello?
Sylvia, hi! This is Jane calling from the production office of Tales of the Space Night. Sorry I'm calling so late.
What? Who is this? Who the fuck is this?
Jane, the production coordinator from Tales of the Space Night.
What?
Listen, I'm looking for Freddy. Is he there?
You got a lot of fucking nerve, you know that?
Yeah, baby, I came from my smokes. Do you want my
Who is that?
That is none of your fucking business.
I came from my smokes. Ah, sweet pig.
You shut up.
What? I'm still horny, man.
Listen to me, I know he's there. Look, I know what's going on, and I'm not judging you, all right? I wouldn't be calling you, Sylvia, if this were not a desperate situation.
The fucking Space Night production office. What's he calling here for? Looking for you, asshole. Did you tell them?
Just give me the fucking phone.
Fuck me.
I already did.
Freddy.
Hey.
Freddy, hi. It's Jane calling from the office.
What's up, Jane?
Well, we need Fauntleroy to save the fucking galaxy tonight, man. Are you up for it?
What? You want me to work now?
How the fuck did you find
me? I fucking know. Look, Jane, I've been drinking all night, eh?
I think that'll be okay.
So this is an added day, right?
My man, this is like overtime.
Yeah, okay, I'll do it. But only on one condition.
Yeah?
Yeah. You can't tell anyone you fucking found me here tonight.
Absolutely. Listen, I'm gonna have transport over to Sylvia's right away to get you, okay?
Yeah, I'll be downstairs in the lobby.
Okay, turn on your phone, Space Knight. Bye.
Bye.
I can't fucking believe you found Fauntleroy.
Thank God. He's kind of drunk, but what do we care?
You're amazing.
Yes, I am. Okay, time to make some victory calls. You call transport, get them over to Sylvia's ASAP.
Yep.
This is Dick. Leave a message? Of course you can.
Well, guess who saved the day? We found Fauntleroy.
Hey there, bro. How you doing? Good morning. Hey, I have a big 911 for you, okay? We need an actor pickup at 345 Carlaw, third floor. All right? And get on it quick. Give me a call as soon as you get there. All right. Bye.
Shelley, this is Jane calling with some very good news. We found Fauntleroy. Now, it's 10 after 5 right now. He should be on set by 5:30, but if you need to talk to him,
we found Fauntleroy. Yeah, ETA, I'm thinking about 20 minutes. And just to let you know,
I hope your morning is much better now.
All right.
Bye.
Bye.
Looks like we're in the home stretch now, Jesse.
Thank God. What a fucking night it's been.
Production.
Hello, Jeanne. Hold on a sec. I'm in Honeyland, copy. So just to update you, the producer was able to talk the actor into coming to set, so we're going to shoot scene 42 next.
I fucking give up.
So we don't need to reschedule that scene after all.
I know that. What do you think I've been doing here all night, Anne?
I have no idea.
I know what's going on because we're the ones who found him, you fucking idiot.
Excuse me?
You heard me, Naylor. And I am tired of covering for your fucking incompetence. No lunch calls, gaps in the schedule, no information whatsoever.
What? How dare you talk to me like that?
You motherfucking piece of shit, cuntbag whore! I will fucking talk to you however I fucking well like!
Butter? Of course you can.
Can I have some peanut butter? Of course you can.
Your leader has arrived.
Whoa, quiet in here.
We need to talk. In private.
Sounds serious. In my chambers. What's going on here? Am I missing something?
Where the fuck have you been all night?
Well, I'm the PM. We're making a movie.
Where the fuck have you been all night?
Hey, will you keep your voice down? We found Fauntleroy. The hell's your problem now?
For Christ's sake, Dick. Naylor?
What?
Of all people, to be fucking on set.
What? Where did you hear this bullshit?
Well? Everyone's talking about it. It was on the call sheet, Dick.
Wow. What are you talking about?
You know what I'm talking about. Admit it.
Admit what? Jane, this is ridiculous.
I am so sick of your fucking lies.
Hey, believe what you goddamn well want. That's always been your MO. Honey, you don't really believe this story.
You
Come
are
on, Jane, let's put
incredible.
All this behind us. Let's go to that B&B in the country that we both like. We'll leave Chloe with Mom and Dad. Be romantic.
Ugh, are you insane? I know you've done this before, but now you've humiliated me at work with someone who's a joke. We joke about Naylor. She's the fucking punchline. This is my career. And now, at my office, I'm the punchline. And I just can't have that. Get up. I can't even look at you anymore. And don't even think about coming home tonight.
Okay. But this isn't over. Just remember, you have this career and this office because of me.
Go back to set. And Justy, make sure you let me know when the New York wardrobe is delivered, all right?
Yeah, sure thing.
Production.
Hey, what up, Janie Jane?
Davey.
Well, the man is through customs.
Great.
You know, I decided to wear that shit. It really shows off my fucking pecs. And that chainmail is making my little nipples rock hard.
Cool.
Hello? All right, what's wrong, Janie? Talk to Daddy. Janie?
Fuck. I don't know. Life just blows.
That's an understatement.
You know, maybe you're right. Maybe this fucking big men are conspiring to keep us down here. Way down here in the fucking bowels below the line.
The bowels below? What the fuck happened to the heartbeat, Janie? You are flatlining, sugar. When have you ever let those cunt scabs get you down? Come on, just do what doctors do when guys want a sex change. Cut their dicks off, turn them inside out, and make them into little, little bitty pussies.
They do that? Do they?
Oh, yeah, I saw that shit on cable last week.
You fucking kill me. Why do you always know the right thing to say?
Because I'm double motherfucking D. I'm built to perform in all motherfucking ways.
All right, listen. Call me when you get there, and call me again when you pass the baton.
Yes, headmistress.
Have a safe flight, baby. Bye.
All good?
Yeah. Is ladies' man's cell phone on the crew list?
Yeah, why?
Because I think it's time for me to plant my own fucking seeds. Discontent.
What the fuck are you up to?
Watch and learn.
Hi, Justin.
Ladies' man, it's Jane.
Oh, Jane. Hey, I'm really sorry
Forget
about
it. That. Forget it. Listen, do you want to keep your job?
Oh, yeah.
Then
yeah,
I need
sure.
you to do something for me.
Okay.
I want you to go back to set with your Downey's fucking charm and find the enchilada's assistant. And when you find her, I want you to tell her that juicy little story you told us tonight
uh-huh.
about Ann Naylor and Dick. Please let this be my production.
Eagle has landed, Janie.
Thank God. Where are you now?
Just hopped in a cab and heading to the fitting at the hotel.
Awesome.
Now, Janie, it's time for you to head home.
No, not until the gown is at the fitting.
Jane, I got it. Just trust me. And trust Justy, too. We will take it from fucking here. No problem.
All right. Thanks.
Holy shit.
What? What now?
Nothing. It is just the sun rising over the Manhattan skyline. It is fucking beautiful.
You have a good time, stud.
Oh, you know that shit for sure. Now you go get some rest.
All right, I will. Bye.
Later, kid.
The double D is in a cab on the way to the hotel.
Sweet.
Yeah. You can take it from here.
Really?
Really.
All right.
All right.
And it looks like we're gonna get our day.
Woo fucking pee. How do you know?
Naylor called with the last shot. Now, when it's all over. Fuck. Production.
Justy, that's a wrap.
Speak of the devil. Did we get our day?
Yes.
Yeah, all that stuff with Fauntleroy?
Yes.
What the fuck are you crying about?
Why? No, why are you being so mean to me?
Because you're a fuck-up, Anne. And you don't take responsibility for your mistakes. You threw this steaming pile of shit on our desks and left it for us to clean up.
Franchement, Justy, pourquoi tu me parles comme ça? Do you know the night I've had?
Oh, I can imagine. Does your jaw hurt?
Oh, you fucking asshole. You're gonna regret this.
Oh, yeah, what are you gonna do about it?
Don't you worry. Shelley will be calling over there soon, and he'll be taking care of both of you. Trotke!
Come, dumpster!
Holy motherfucking shit. What happened to your inner emo?
Yeah, I think it's gone.
Yeah, I'll say.
She was crying.
Yeah? Well, fucking cry, bitch.
Yeah, well, don't get too excited. She said the enchilada would be calling and that we'd be taken care of.
Great. That's just fucking great. So, I guess you haven't heard from ladies, man.
Not a peep.
Well, so much for my brilliant idea. You know, fuck them all. I don't give a shit anymore. You know what? We get that fucking actor to set against all odds and get fired for reaming out the producer's fuck toy?
Hey, you know what? Let's not give him the satisfaction. We should quit instead. I mean, it's kind of like we're just sitting ducks here, right? Working at our desks, waiting for the planes to hit.
You sound like Double D now.
Well, that gitch, chew, and choke fucking freak makes a lot of sense sometimes.
Okay, so what do you want to do? You want to jump out of a window?
No. Let's storm out with our sabers at the ready. Space Knights.
Excelsior! Fuck you.
Fuck you.
Jane, I have to speak with you. Privately, in here. Jane, I'm aware that certain situations tonight have spun completely out of control.
I would like to set the record straight on a few things myself here, Shelley.
Let me finish what I'm going to say.
Okay.
Thank you. Now, my assistant has brought certain information to my attention, which brings some very serious issues to light. Some very, very serious, egregious instances of professional malfeasance.
If you're talking about my conversation with Ann Naylor.
No, but I am talking about Ann, and I am talking about your husband, Dick. Now, because of these revelations, I'm convinced that the whole Lord Fauntleroy situation, which you handled admirably, I might add, was largely due to carelessness on Ann's part.
Really?
Yes. And your husband, Dick, bears a great deal of the brunt of that blame as well, which has forced me to make some drastic changes. Both Anne and Dick have been dismissed, and that's effective immediately.
Oh.
Now, I know that might cause some difficulty for you at home. But I have a proposition for you, which might further complicate things, but let me get to the point. I want you to take over Dick's job.
Me?
Yes.
Are you serious?
Yes.
Jane,
make a decision.
I don't know.
What's the hesitation? You'd be great at this. You're a natural.
Okay, yeah, yes. I will take the job.
Good, that's more like it.
Thank you, Shelley.
Okay, so first of all, get some sleep, and we'll talk about the details tomorrow in New York, of course.
In New York.
Well, need help packing?
Holy shit.
What?
Tricky and Naylor are both gone. Fired.
What?
I didn't think the enchilada would fire them.
Well, all right, ladies, man.
And he offered me Tricky's job.
Well, did you tell him to go fuck himself?
No.
Oh, you're not thinking about taking it now, are you?
I already did.
But what about the life? What happens below the line stays below the line. Excelsior, fuck you, huh?
You don't believe that shit, do you?
Oh, so now you want to be above the line?
Eventually.
What the fuck are you talking about?
What I'm talking about is I am gonna need someone to take over my job, and I think you are the perfect choice.
Me?
Yeah, you. I need somebody down here I can trust. And you trained with the master.
Well, that is true.
But you might not be able to play the Lizard Lounge.
That is so gay.
So fucking gay. Well, what do you say? Will you do this for me?
Yeah. Yeah, I'll do it. What the fuck?
Right on.
God, only in the film business could this happen.
I am gonna go home and get some Z's.
Hey, does this mean I get your rolly chair now?
Not on your fucking life.
Shit.
Shit. Thanks for everything today. I really mean that.
It's what I'm here for, boss.
Come on. Let's hug it out, bitch.
I got it. Get the fuck out of here. Production.
Justy, it's Terry from camera. Listen, man, those cans of
7289
stock,
we never
got it. No, but we didn't get the stock.
Yeah, well, crying to me ain't gonna help.
But the cans are not here, man.
Stop. Just give me the information. I need only the information.
Okay, listen, I went to the camera truck, and the stock that I had ordered, the 7289 stock, is not there. We need it for New York, man. But what are we gonna do?
Hey, Jane. It's a fucking wrap, eh?
It sure as hell fucking is. Oh, God. Retard. Good morning, sunshine. Mommy's on her way home. Yes, I'll definitely make you pancakes. Okay, I'll see you soon, okay, sweetie? Bye. All right. Woohoo! Get me out of here.
Fuck up. Big men are in control. Always fucking have been. Always fucking will be.